Hello and welcome to DCBA. We'll find this deflection at B using Cassegrainer's method. So let us solve it. First, we need to identify the load causing deflection. So it is equal to W. Then we need to apply the Cassegrainer's imaginary load. Imaginary load at the point where we require the deflection. So we require the deflection at B and the load will be equal to P. So we can write this as W plus P because we have applied it in the same direction and at the point B. Third is we need to find the MX equation. So I'll take X here and basically I need to find the MX at this point. But in semicircular problems, what will happen is that you cannot work very smoothly with using Cartesian coordinates. You need to switch into polar coordinates. So basically what we can do is that we have a radius r and we have this theta. So I can express this x in terms of r and theta, isn't it? So we can express this x like x is equal to r sine theta and dx is equal to r d theta. Okay. So mx can be written as mx is basically minus of w plus p into x, but x is equal to r sin theta, so it is minus of w plus p into r sin theta, and dou mx by dou p is equal to, this will be 0 since it's a constant, we'll get minus of 0 plus 1 into r sin theta, which is equal to minus of r sin theta. Okay. Now there's also one more term that we need to convert. Since our delta was equal to integration of a to b, mx dou mx by dou p into dx divided by e i. So we also have this dx which we need to convert in terms of d theta, right? So dx is basically the small parts, okay? These small parts that we divide our b, that is called as dx, the small part of your beams. So since, let us say this is the small part dx, okay, and which is subtended by an angle of d theta. So I can express dx as equal to, I can write dx is equal to r d theta by the arc formula, right? We can write dx is equal to r into d theta. So now delta is equal to, now your theta has to travel from, say where theta is equal to 0, your theta has to travel from here all the way like this till theta equal to 180 degrees, or is it is equal to 2 pi. I'm sorry, it is equal to pi. So your delta is 0 to pi and mx is equal to minus of w plus p r sin theta into dou mx by dou p is minus r sin theta into dx is r d theta divided by EI, which is equal to 0 to pi W plus P R cube upon EI sine square theta D theta, right? So I can write this as W. Oh right, and I can now cancel the imaginary load, that is P. So I'll just write a W R Q upon E I, and the sine theta I'll express it in terms of cos to theta. So 0 to pi 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2 into d theta, okay, and it is equal to W R cube upon 2i, the integration, this 2i, I have taken it outside. So the integration would be theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 going from 0 to pi. So it is equal to w r cube over 2 ei and pi minus sine 2 pi is 0, so pi minus 0 minus 0 minus 0, therefore delta is equal to w r cube upon 2 ei into pi by 2. Okay, so this is your